Some of you love a little sip, sip, sip. Yeah? Feeling good? You know, I was born in 1980. Yeah. No, I really, really appreciate this. I'm second generation up at this stage, and this is the third time. I really, really appreciate you guys. So, let's rock and roll, okay? Just let me hear some of the rock and roll music.
Historic Amuzu Theater's third annual rock and roll show. Our opening number was rock and roll music performed by Andy Wayne Williams. This recording by Chuck Berry reached number 8 on the top 40 charts back in 1957. Jerry Butler's For Your Precious Love reached number 11 in 1958, and Wayne Harris is our lead singer on this enduring ballad.
Yeah.
1961, Sue Thompson reached number 5 on the Hickory label, and that was our own Kelly Annis recalling the emotion of Thompson's hit, Sad Movies. All right, let's welcome now J.D. Dillahunt to lead us in Yakety Yak, the number 1 hit for the Coasters in 1958.
Don't go out.
Please, Mr. Postman, find that special letter. This song took the Marvelettes to number one in 1961. Number 7 and stayed on the charts for 15 weeks with this hit.
Thank you.
Presley's Don't Be Cruel reached number one in 1956 and stayed on the charts for 24 weeks.
We know I can't be found sitting home all alone. If you can come around, at least please tell them all. Don't be cruel, too hard is true. Baby, if you're a handyman, something that I might have said, please let's get on back. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel, too hard is true.
Skeeter Davis took the number two back in 1963.
Do they know?
1960, Maurice Williams and the Zodiacs climbed the charts to number one on the Herald label, pleading with the lady to stay just a little bit longer.
Stay!
recalls Ray Charles' dreamy classic, I Can't Stop Loving You. From 1962, it reached number one on the ABC Paramount label.
We'll be right back.
books of love have been written, but the Monotones rocked this song to number 5 on the charts in 1958. And our trio comes back now to question, who wrote the Book of Love?
I wonder, wonder who did it.
No, no.
Party Doll from 1957 made it the number one on the roulette label, and Herb Linesburg brings us a selection with a guitar solo by Andy Williams.
Through my head,
charts for 20 weeks in 1955.
Only you can make this world seem right. Only you.
In October 1957, RCA released the Elvis Christmas album. It spent 4 weeks at number one, and according to the Recording Industry Association of America, it shipped at least 13 million copies in the United States alone. It's the first Elvis title to attain Diamond certification, and it's the best-selling Christmas album of all time in the U.S. So as a preview of the Christmas show that we're preparing for December, we now feature Santa, Bring My Baby Back to Me, which was originally written for that album. By outstanding girl groups like the Supremes. So in 1965, hit number one with an exclamated stop in the name of love. Wantana Frink brings Diana Ross to our stage, and along with Lara and Grace as her Supremes, they take us to the end of Act One and intermission.